if you look at today's digital computers, there is very good understanding of how they work, what kind of digital circuitry is used behind them, and they work and operate on a concept of two stable states. Two stable states are actually, that's what why we call them digital, because there is a bit and an absence of bit. So it's like zero and one, and that's why digital computer have two states that we talk about. Quantum computing comes from a very different angle, which talks about there are two states, zero and one, and there are all other states which are, let's say, superimposition of zero and one, which makes it too many states to comprehend. And it's the act of observing that all of those superimposition of so many states collapses into one stable state. And that exactly makes it very interesting and very, spooky to say. But then quantum is there in this entire universe everywhere, wherever, let's say, you have matter. And if you think about why it is so powerful, because now if you could create a computer with that massive scale of states, and if you could, let's say, devise algorithms which could work with that kind of superimposition of states, you could actually create very, very powerful computers, which even today's computers would probably take beyond the age of universe to solve. And they could probably solve those problems in a matter of few minutes or maybe hours.
Wow.